Michael C. Hall.
Amazing, you know. I thought the cup of water joke was funny. Another thing that I don't like, and you might be surprised here, I'm not really crazy about porn. Not so much. Boo, porn is awesome. But hey, porn is awesome for dudes who, you know, are cool and can deal with it. I'm so insecure, right? When I watch porn, I just feel left out. I'm like, man, I sure wish I could do what they were doing. All two or three or four, or her and the midget and the donkey, or, you know, whatever you're into. So, yeah, it's rough. So, and speaking of painful shit, I'm going through a divorce currently. Anybody divorced? Where you at? Divorced people rock. I'm a man twice. He's proud of me. Why she would leave me. I mean, look at me. I'm a stand-up comedian, which means I have the emotional development of a retarded 12-year-old. I have the earning potential of an illiterate, illegal immigrant. And I have the body of a really, really dysfunctional third grader. So, you know, why would she leave me? You know what I mean? Why would she leave all this? And I have to tell you, you know, divorce is tough, man. It hurts sometimes. It's like, for all you single people out there, especially you dudes, when you roll up on a chick at a club and ask her to dance or try to buy her a drink and she rejects you and that little pain you feel, imagine that for 10 years, okay? And it's not like I don't like you, I don't think you're cute enough to buy me a drink, it's I hate you, I hate the way you breathe, and I hate the way you eat, and I hate the way your socks smell, motherfucker. So yeah, divorce can be tough, man, divorce can be tough. And so, you know, it's rejection. I will say also that, you know, a lot of stuff makes me angry. I try to be a happy guy, I try to be a normal guy, try to come out here and have a lot of fun, but there's a lot of little things that make me angry lately. And, you know, one of the things that makes me angry, the other day I'm in traffic, right? And right behind me on an SUV in big letters, it says, "Riding Dirty." Damn right. Man, here's the thing about it, though. If you're riding dirty, why would you fucking advertise that shit, dude? You know what I mean? Why don't you just get a fucking sticker that says, "Officer, please pull me over." You know? Here's the thing, riding dirty means you have illegal substances in your car, white guy. Okay? Not that you're familiar. However, why would you advertise the fact that you have illegal substances in your car? White people fuck shit up for everyone. Anyway, trust me, I know. Oh, man. Another thing that pisses me off is going to Long's. Anybody here ever go to Long's drugstore and get something quick?
Long's!
Yes. Here's the thing, I don't mind Long's itself, but you know what I do mind? I mind the fact that I always get stuck behind, I'll wait, it's cool, I'm not doing comedy or anything. Shut the fuck up. Anyway, so, I'm in Long's, right? And here's my problem. I go into Long's, I want like a vitamin water, a pack of cigarettes, and maybe some cream for that rash. But anyway, I got like three items, I'm in and out. I'm in a hurry, you know what I mean? But the problem is, I always get behind that 80-year-old, very nice lady, and it's double coupon day, and she's got 80 cans of tuna, you know? And I'm like, and I can't trip. I gotta be cool and smile, because I don't want everybody in Long's to think I'm that white guy. You know what I mean? Like, oh, he's that dick white dude who doesn't care. This old lady needs her tuna. She's probably got 47 cats to feed, okay? It's on special. It's double coupon. Another thing that pisses me off, do you guys hear Final Destination 6 is coming out? You guys hear about that? Okay, so there's a movie coming out called Final Destination 6. Now, if you're like me and you have any kind of understanding of the English language, then you would understand that Final Destination 6 is fucking impossible! There's only one Final Destination! If it was yet another Final Destination, destination for other people I could see. Or if it was the sixth installment in stories about people who have final destinations, fair enough. But Final Destination 6 just pisses me off. It does. Oh, man, no material. Oh, and finally, another thing that really pisses me off is that, I don't know if you saw this on CNN the other day, but this chick about a year ago got her face ripped off by a chimpanzee, right?
Yeah.
Now, if you've seen, she's in the news. She's got like her own hour-long special coming out, and they put a new face on her. And I thought, what a dumbass I am for the last 10 years trying to write jokes and entertain people in bars. I need to just go get a monkey really pissed off. I mean, I would kill for an hour special, are you kidding? Come on, I would probably rip somebody's face off. I just thought of that. Anyway, and finally, hang in there with me on this one, people. I don't know about y'all, but for me, I am getting sick and tired of people emailing me YouTube videos of retarded people doing mundane shit, and that's supposed to be inspirational. Oh yeah, I just said it. You know what I mean? The last one I got, I swear to God, I got this one last week. It's a dude with no arms and no legs, plunking out a tune on a piano, ding-ding-ding-ding-ding-ding-ding-ding. And I'm like, that's supposed to be inspirational to me? He's got that kind of time. He can't even beat off. Really? I would be fucking a master pianist if I had no arms and no legs and somebody slid one over to my face. You know? But this guy, you know what I mean? That's supposed to inspire me to get up and go to work. What I want to see is a chubby, depressed, divorced comedian with no money get the fuck up, put his pants and his shirt on, and go find a day job. That shit would be inspirational to me, people.
Yeah!
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? That would make me feel good. Yeah. Nice. Ding, 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 ding. You can do it! No. Yeah, son, it got rough. And y'all thought Pal C was bad. Oh, what else? Oh, but I have hope. I have hope, guys. I want you to know that I have hope. I recently discovered what a cuckold is. Nobody know? Who knows what a cuckold is? Let me hear you. So you got a hot couple, right? Like, nobody in here, but a hot couple. You've all seen them. Brad and Angelina Jolie, that kind of thing, right? So you've got a hot... Oh, there's a hot couple right there, so... Anyway, so what the cuckold is if you were really fucked up and degenerate, you would have me do you while he watched as a form of sexual denigration if I was the cuckold. So I have hope that I'm actually going to get laid again. Yeah! Because I can be that guy. I can follow around football players and their model chicks and be like, cuckold for hire, hi! You know what I mean? I can do that. I think I can. So I'm going to pull that off. So, and finally, I got a quick question for you. Are you guys frightened and confused by this Trojans Triforia commercial like I am? Have you ever seen it? The Triforia commercial? Yeah! Okay, throw your hair back. Exactly. Okay, so the Triforia is a female... Oh, it's a dildo. Okay, I was gonna say it's a dildo, right? Now, here's the thing about the Triforia. It's made by Trojans, and it's brilliant, because women don't want to come home after a hard day, light candles, put on some Chardonnay, and do it with a dildo. They want to do it with the Triforias. But the commercial is really messed up, because this is what the commercial says. The commercial, this chick is at a party and she gets three of them, and she's like, yay, three Triforias. And I'm like, how big is her pussy? She needs three? And then the commercial goes and she meets her husband and she's like, I got three Triforias. And he's all, sweet. Which leads me again to wonder, how big is her fucking pussy? That her husband is celebrating that fact. I want to thank you guys all so much for coming out and letting me be filthy and offensive for 10 minutes. Thank you for supporting comedy. I love you guys. I'm Michael C. Hall. ComedyMoney.com. Support James Money. Good night.
Michael C. Hall. Now we know what the C stands for. Michael Cuckold's Hall. Sweet. You know, as a bus driver, I wish I would meet my final destination sometime.